सर्वमंगल मांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके शरण्ये त्र्यंबके गौरी नारायणी नमोस्तुते। नमः सभायै सभापतिभ्यश्च। रेस्पेक्टेड प्रोफेसर हरे कृष्ण सतपथी, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर किस यूनिवर्सिटी भुवनेश्वर इंडिया, रेस्पेक्टेड प्रोफेसर प्रफुल्ल कुमार मिश्र, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी बिहार इंडिया, रेस्पेक्टेड प्रोफेसर अरुण रंजन मिश्र, डॉक्टर फिलोमेना, प्रोफेसर समानाथ साहू, डॉक्टर मनोरंजन सेनापति, डॉक्टर हीरालाल दास, डॉक्टर गीतांजलि नायक, रेस्पेक्टेड एल्डर्स, डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स, माय ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, ग्रीटिंग्स ऑल ऑफ यू फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका, द लैंड ऑफ ग्रेट नेल्सन मंडेला एंड ऑल्सो व्हेयर महात्मा गांधी स्टार्टेड हिज सत्याग्रह। ऑन दिस इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार ऑन टॉपिक ऑफ राष्ट्र निर्माणे संस्कृतम, दैट मीन्स संस्कृत एंड नेशन बिल्डिंग्स। एट आउटसेट आई लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ संस्कृत, नॉर्थ ओडिशा यूनिवर्सिटी केउंझर कैंपस इंडिया एंड भिला मेरी डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन हैदराबाद इंडिया फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑन राष्ट्र निर्माणे संस्कृतम और संस्कृत एंड नेशन बिल्डिंग। आई हैव डिवाइडेड दिस टॉक इनटू थ्री पॉइंट्स। वन इज दैट द डिबेट इन इंडियन पार्लियामेंट वेयर दे डिस्कस द इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ संस्कृत फॉर नेशन बिल्डिंग्स, एंड पॉइंट नंबर टू रिपोर्ट ऑफ संस्कृत कमीशन वेयर दे ऑल्सो मेंशन द इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ संस्कृत फॉर नेशन बिल्डिंग, एंड पॉइंट नंबर थ्री हाउ टू टेक फॉरवर्ड संस्कृत। ऑन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट द डिबेट इन इंडियन पार्लियामेंट ऑन इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ संस्कृत फॉर नेशन बिल्डिंग्स। इन सेप्टेम्बर 1949 एट द हाइट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबलीज fraught debate over the future official language of India. One of its members from Assam, Kuladhar Chalia, a former tea planter and lawyer, declared, "We will become better Indians by adopting Sanskrit as the national language because Sanskrit and India are coextensive." He was not alone in those expressing his faith in language, but about other 27 members made a similar proposal. Among them was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was the chairman of the drafting committee and who was leading spokespersons of Dalit community, T.T. Krishnamurti, G. Durgabai Deshmukh, Pandit Lakshmikanta Mishra, and Naziruddin Ahmad, who was the member of Muslim League. Like that, large number of members of parliament, they supported on favor of Sanskrit, and also a large number of those supported the cause of Sanskrit were from Madras and West Bengal, where people are complaining that if we'll make Sanskrit national language, might South Indian or maybe West Bengal, they won't support. But on that parliament, most of the members were from South India and West Bengal, they supported in favor of the Sanskrit. So that was the debate on the Indian parliament. If we'll make Sanskrit as a national language, we'd have a better India. On the second point, that the report of Sanskrit Commission. In October 1956, the government of India decided to appoint a Sanskrit Commission to evaluate the state of Sanskrit in nation. The reason for creating the Sanskrit Commission was the University Education Commission, chaired by Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan in 1948-49, the Secondary School Education Commission under A. Lakshmanaswamy Mudaliar in 1952-53, the Official Language Commission, chaired by B.G. Kher in 1955-56, that all the three commissions had proclaimed their faith in value of Sanskrit education for the Indian citizen. Also, much concern was voiced by these commissions over a perceived decline in Sanskrit learning, which it was feared would eventually lead to the elimination of the language if the government did not step in and prevent a national disaster. So here the commission is saying, if we will not promote Sanskrit, and it might lead to a national disaster on the topic of language. That is why Government of India in October 1956 set up a Sanskrit commission under the chairmanship of renowned linguistic Suniti Kumar Chatterjee, who was to be added in his task by seven established Sanskrit scholars, who included V. Raghavan of the University of Madras, R. N. Dandekar from University of Pune, S. K. De of Jadavpur University of Calcutta. The report was submitted after a 1 year, November 1957. That is, so its task as being more than just educational, for at stake was the very survival of the emergent India. To free India from regionalism and linguism and for build India as a nation, the commission recommended to put Indians on a good and steady diet of Sanskrit by making its study compulsory in schools and by instituting it as the official language of nation. Because on the page number 201, they mentioned Sanskrit was ideally suited this role, for it was the supreme unifier. So commission mentioned in page number 201, Sanskrit is the supreme unifier. And page number 81, it also mentioned Sanskrit is the great unifying force. In page number 85, the Indian people and the Indian civilization were born in the lap of Sanskrit. In page number 81 mentioned, it is in our blood. In page number 87, it mentioned, it is the breath of our nostril and the light of our eyes. In page number 102, it mentioned, mixing its metaphor, the commission also variously described Sanskrit as the bedrock of Indian existence, the main thread which run through the entire fabric of the cultural life of an Indian. In page number 51, it mentioned, and the anchor that keeps the youth of India from losing their cultural moorings. In page number 70, it mentioned, if the binding force of Sanskrit is taken away, the people of India would cease to feel that we are part of a single culture and a single nation. And also in page number 84, it mentioned, so by restoring Sanskrit back to its citizens, the nations too would be restored and its troubled waters calmed. For Sanskrit, it was declared, brings a symphony to our life. So this was the report of Sanskrit commissions about the role of Sanskrit to make a better India. But unfortunately, till date, Sanskrit is not a national language of India. So my point, if we make Sanskrit national language of India, definitely we have a better India and we will be progress more and more. So in this point, is a duty of our Sanskrit scholars and Sanskrit Vidwan, how to take forward Sanskrit. So on third point, I'll put few suggestions how to take forward Sanskrit. We have to go in two way. One is, we try our best to make Sanskrit as a link language of India. That means we must promote spoken Sanskrit in schools, in colleges, even in privately. We must do how to make Sanskrit as a spoken language, and that will lead as a link language. And second point also, we must promote Sanskrit as Devabhasa Sanskritam. That means we must promote Sanskrit mantras, Sanskrit prayers, and that will bring and will make encourage the people to learn Sanskrit and they'll understand the benefit of Sanskrit. But one thing, the real problem when you're teaching the Sanskrit mantra, Sanskrit prayers, that when we teach that one, it problem make that when you make Hindu dharma as a Hindu religion or Bauddha dharma as a Bauddha religion, or when we say Jaina dharma as a Jaina religion, that obstruct to promote Sanskrit mantras and Sanskrit prayers. So what you can do, if you will make understand dharma means not religion, and that will help to promote Sanskrit mantras and Sanskrit prayers, then people understand the benefit of Sanskrit. With that, I like to thank the North Odisha University Second Campus Keunjhar and Bhila Mary Degree College for Women Hyderabad organizing this wonderful international webinar on the topic of Rashtra Nirmane Sanskritam, that means Sanskrit and nation building. Thank you so much. Om Shantihi, 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 Jayatu Bharatam, Jayatu Sanskritam, Jayatu Dharma.